Lupita.
Sí, señor Pepe.
Oye, cuando llegue Mia Califa, ¿las pasar, por favor?
Ya llegó. ¿Quiere que la pase?
Pásamela. Claro que sí. Muchachos, después de 2 años de insistencia de parte de ustedes e insistencia a su manager de parte mía, finalmente tenemos a Mia Califa.
Hola,
Hola,
Pepe.
Mia, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien, ¿y
Bienvenida,
tú?
muchas gracias.
Igualmente.
Gracias por aceptar venir. Toma asiento.
Oh, muchas gracias.
Hablo despacio porque sé que hablas un poquito español.
Hablo poquita español.
Ok, bienvenida. Muchachos chaqueteros, no tengo que presentarles a esta chica. Ustedes ya saben muy bien quién es y vamos a platicar con ella. Tienes muchos fans en Latinoamérica, en México. Muchos me han escrito que te quieren mucho y que querían que te invitara. ¿Qué le quieres decir? ¿Sabías que tienes tantos fans en Latinoamérica?
Yeah, I have a lot of fans in Latin America, and all of them ask to see my feet all the time. I don't know why.
¿Your feet?
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, that's all they ask for. They just ask for pictures of my feet all the time. Mostly Brazil, though. It's
Wow.
mostly Brazil that asks for pictures of
Okay.
my feet.
And do you tour over there? No?
Never.
No?
No, I'm scared that my feet will get cut off.
Ah, no. No. They can kiss your feet.
No.
No, no.
No, I'm scared they'll keep them.
No. How weird.
Yeah. Yeah,
But
Mexico's always nice to me though. They just invite me over to eat.
have you been there?
No, I haven't, but I used to live in El Paso, where I went to school, and that was right on the border of Juarez. But it was very dangerous to go to Juarez at the time.
Totalmente.
Yeah.
¿En qué año viviste en El Paso? 2000.
2011 to 2014 en escuela.
¿Fuiste al college?
University of Texas, El Paso.
Okay. You finish or what?
¿Sí?
¿Sí?
Sí.
¿Qué estudiaste?
History.
Oh my God. Qué bien.
American history.
La historia americana.
Sí.
Buenísimo. ¿Dónde naciste?
Oh, Beirut, Lebanon.
En el Líbano.
Yeah.
Muy rica comida del Líbano.
You like Lebanese food?
Of
Oh my
course, I love
God.
it.
I love it too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there is some Lebanese restaurants in Texas?
No, but there is in LA, which is why I'm moving here.
Okay.
Yeah, I need the better food. The better Mexican food, the better Lebanese food.
What are you doing now? What's your job right now? I was checking your Instagram, modeling, talking with some TV personalities.
My main job is modeling and YouTube. I sell posters on my Patreon, which is a website, but mainly I just do modeling, and I also co-founded an app for soccer that rates referees.
Okay.
So users can go on there and rate referees depending on their performance, and it shows statistics and analytics of each performance that the ref has against every team.
You have a YouTube
See.
channel, right?
See.
What's the name? How the people can check your post or your videos on YouTube channel?
It's the DC Sports Girl.
The DC
Sports Girl.
Sports
Yeah, because
Girl.
I'm from DC and I love sports. And I kind of stole it from the Boston sports guy.
Okay.
I'm the DC Sports Girl.
Okay, awesome. You said you are from Washington, D.C.?
Yeah, so when I moved away from Lebanon, I was 10 years old. We escaped the civil war that was going on over there. And we moved to Washington, D.C. And then I lived there until I was 18. And then I went to college in El Paso. And then I moved to Miami after that.
¿Y hablabas inglés cuando llegaste a Estados Unidos?
I didn't speak English when I was in Lebanon. I learned English in America. Is that what you were asking? Okay.
Yes. Oh my God. Habla español.
Yeah. I
Tenía.
remember it from college.
Okay. Oh, so in college you have the
Well,
Spanish
everywhere
lesson.
I worked, I worked at a Mexican restaurant, and to bully me, they only spoke to me in Spanish because I was the only girl there who wasn't Mexican.
Yes.
So, I mean, they all spoke English, but just to be mean to me, they only spoke to me in Spanish.
¿Y cuál era tu trabajo en el restaurante?
So first I started as a waitress, and then
Okay.
I was such a bad waitress that they made me be a bartender, and then I was such a bad bartender that they made me be a hostess, and then I messed up so much at being a hostess that they put me
Get
in the
fired.
kitchen just like warming up tortillas. No, they didn't fire me. I tried. I was just bad at
No.
it.
Ahora tú eres el sueño de muchos jóvenes, de muchos muchachos en el mundo. Y especialmente en mi público que está en Latinoamérica. Pero todo el mundo nos imaginamos que tienes muchos candidatos para ser tu novio. Pero, ¿alguna vez te gustaba alguien y te rechazó? ¿Fuiste... ¿alguna vez alguien que te gustaba no te hacía caso? No tenía, ¿tuviste una época que no tenía suerte como los muchachos?
Oh my God. I used to weigh 50 pounds more than this, and I didn't have boobs. Mm-hmm. And I mean, obviously the nose is still a problem, but we can fix that later. So, no, I asked a boy to prom in high school, and he said no to me. And then I asked a second boy to prom in high school, and he also said no to me. So I ended up not going to prom in high school. I never got hit on in college. Even after I lost the weight, I just looked like a boy because I didn't have any boobs. Like, I was just a skinny little boy-looking thing. Mm-hmm. So, no. I always got rejected. Wow. I'm very used to rejection.
And now it's in your face when you have so many invitations, I think.
No, now it's fun to reject people. Now it's payback time.
Yeah, I can imagine. ¿Qué es lo que te enamora de un hombre?
Oh, definitely the way he treats other people and whether or not he can cook. And I found the perfect man who is kind to everybody he meets, and everybody who meets him falls in love with him just because he's so genuine. Like, he truly wants the best for everybody he meets, and he has such a big heart that I've never heard him say a bad thing about anybody. He just says, oh, they must be going through something hard. I hope they figure out a way past this. And, you know, I'm the complete opposite. Somebody doesn't hold the door open for me, and I'm like, I hope the mother dies. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. Yeah, no. Oh my God, I'm kidding. But you know what I mean. He makes me a nicer person, and that's what I look for in a man. Somebody who makes me want to be a better person.
Fantastic. So this guy cooks.
Yes, that's him right there.
Yeah. The guy cooks?
He cooks. He's an amazing chef. He's one of the best chefs in the world.
He looks like a macaroni and cheese, and that's it, no?
Yes, he makes amazing macaroni and cheese. He made me the best bowl of cereal. Oh my God, Pepe, let me tell you. You've never had a bowl of cereal the way he pours it. Mm-hmm. Mm. You're ignoring me.
No.
¿Cuáles serán las materias favoritas tuyas en la escuela?
So, the reason I picked history is because it never felt like work. I always thought history was very interesting. And the entire time I was in school, studying didn't feel like something, you know, like, oh God, I have to study. It was actually intriguing and captivating. So history was my favorite subject. So I majored in it. And then I graduated and I'm like, well, shit, I can't do anything with a history degree, like, except teach. So...
Okay.
Yeah.
So
it was a bad decision, but it was fun.
I think if you love the history,
I do. I
yeah.
love it.
Do you think you can be a teacher?
No, God, no. I shouldn't be allowed within 100 yards of a school.
Okay. What do you think is your biggest talent?
My biggest talent, complaining.
Oh my God, that's not a talent.
I'm really good at finding something to complain about no matter where I am. I feel like that's a true talent.
I don't think so. I think all the girls are like you. They're looking for all the time. In Spanish, we say hacerla de pedo. Mexican, we think, the Mexican men think that the girls...
complain about everything.
And said, okay, I complain.
Yeah.
At this moment.
The sky's not blue enough today. No. I think my best talent is actually picking up languages very fast, because my boyfriend is Swedish, and after about 3 months of being with him, I can speak enough Swedish as a 1.5-year-old child who is just learning. So I feel like that's good for 3 months.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
I can
get by.
I have 20 years in the United States, and I cannot say that I speak English well.
Yeah.
So you have talent to learn.
Yeah, I pick up languages pretty fast. Like, I listen to a lot of Italian and French music, and when I listen to Italian conversations and French conversations, I recognize words, and I can form those words together and understand what they're saying, which is how, mm-hmm. in a long, you know, question from you, I can gather what you are saying.
What language speaks in Lebanese?
In Lebanon, it's mostly French and Lebanese.
Okay, and do you still...
I speak Lebanese fluently.
¿Tienes familia con los que hablas en Lebanese?
I have some family in Lebanon, but most of my family is in America, and they all speak Lebanese.
So, ¿no viajas muy frecuentemente? You don't travel often?
Oh, I'm home like 5 days a month. I travel so much.
Okay.
I'm barely home. My dogs don't recognize me when I come home.
And how many dogs and what kind? What
I have two dogs. Dogs, and they're both very, very small. It's a Maltese and Yorkie, and then one is a Maltese poodle.
Oh,
they're
okay.
Very cute.
Okay, and the names?
Toulouse and Princess. And Toulouse is the boy, and he has a defect. Actually, when I went to the store to get him, before they showed him to me, they said, "We have to warn you, he's defective, but we'll give you 20% off of him." And I'm like, what, is he missing a leg? Like, let me see him. And they bring him out, and he has a really bad overbite, so his tongue all the time is like this.
Cool, yeah. So never.
Yeah, sleep. I'm like, are you kidding me? I will pay extra for that. Give me him. He's mine.
Sleeping in.
Oh, it's all the time. It's so cute.
Oh, my God. Well, I have one.
What kind?
Well, I have two dogs. My friend Hacking and my daughter's dog. Her name is Quesadilla.
Oh!
She's here. Quesadilla is here. Okay. Muchos mensajes. Well, I show you the picture.
You show me now.
Okay, I will.
I want to see the dogs.
Quesadillas, picture and Hacking. Okay, this is Hacking. He's my boy.
Oh my God!
Yeah, he's like.
Mm-hmm. He looks like a bear.
Yeah, yeah. He's a big head.
Oh my God! Yeah. He has the kindest face.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah,
I'm gonna cry. He's so cute.
Hacking, and let me show you Quesadilla. She's Quesadilla.
Oh, that's a chubby dog.
Yeah.
This is me after two burritos. Oh, my God. Mm-hmm. That's a good name. Mm-hmm. That's a good name.
Yeah. So, you said burritos. ¿Te gustan los burritos?
Sí. Mm-hmm.
¿De qué? ¿Qué? What do you put inside?
Everything.
Asada?
Everything I can. Mm-hmm. Everything I can.
Did you know that the burritos is not a Mexican food?
No, I know. It's a Tex-Mex food.
Yes,
yeah.
It is.
But
yeah.
I will say I do prefer plain regular tacos over mm-hmm. The tacos that you get at
no salt, cream and cheese. No,
all I want is cilantro, onion, and whatever meat you put on there. Sorry,
exactly.
No cursing.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Lebanon has a connection with Mexico. Al pastor.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Al pastor.
Yeah, they the meat on. Mm-hmm. The, yeah, exactly.
Like this, and they put some in Mexico City. They put piña, pineapple on it. Yeah,
I
hate
like
that.
Me either. I hate it so much.
Yeah.
I love the meat, and I still get it, but I pick the pineapple out.
Yeah, that's the Chilangos style. That guy's from Mexico City.
This is your fault.
Yeah, they got the pineapple.
Yeah, no.
No,
It's delicious, but everything about it is great, but the pineapple. You ruin everything.
Okay. No sé si les había platicado que Mague ya no está en la compañía, ya no va a aparecer en todos los videos cuando digo Mague. Ella originalmente pues era mi asistente y estuvo muchísimos años conmigo, agradecidísimo con todo su trabajo, pero necesito otra asistente y vamos a ver si Mia Khalifa califica para este puesto. Okay, if you move to LA, you're gonna have delicious food, and if you're looking for a job,
I will
you like the media, you can be my assistant, because my sister just quit.
Wait, really?
Yeah. My assistant just quit like 1 week ago, and I'm looking for an assistant. If you know someone, if you
I can only apply if you don't call any of my references.
Okay. Well, fine. Let's try. Can I ask you some questions?
Yes.
All right. ¿Te gustaría trabajar en la radio? ¿Por qué te gustaría trabajar en una estación de radio?
Why do I like working with the radio?
Yes.
Because there is a lot of time where I have to be outside of the room, so I can spend a lot of that time when you're in here recording on my phone, probably shopping.
Muy bien. Okay. Are you early person or not? Or are you,
I can promise you that I will show up on time at least once a week. That's a promise. I don't know if I can keep that promise, but I will promise it.
No, I don't think you are the right person for this.
I make great coffee.
Okay, really?
Sí.
But I don't need coffee at the afternoon. Si no vas a venir temprano.
What kind of Mexican are you? You should drink coffee all the time.
Yeah, I'm drinking all the time, pero me gusta también desde temprano.
You know, Keurigs have a timer that I can set up and it'll just make it for you.
You're a very practical person.
Thank you. Thank you.
You have skills to convince people, artists to come to the interviews or festivals, whatever?
I have two. Yeah. Very large skills to convince people to do anything I want.
Okay. Well, how much money do you think it's enough for you to live in this city? And what are your expectations regarding the money?
I will take nothing less than 20% more than what you make.
So you are very smart. Have you ever worked on the media?
If I say yes, are you going to fact check?
No.
Then yes, I have worked plenty in the media.
Oh, yeah.
I had 12 years
experience in the media. I saw you on TV sports channel, right?
Yes. Yes. I've had two sports shows.
Okay, is that
both of them got canceled, but we don't need to look into that.
Oh, is that the position that you're looking for? Like a sports
commentator? Like sports commentator.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to do that. Yes, do you have a sports position here? Mm. I can say goal really loud and for a really long time.
Oh, okay, awesome. Can you right now?
Yes, okay.
Nada más me falta una prueba para ver si puede quedarse con este trabajo. Mía.
¿Qué onda, Pepe?
Oye, necesitamos empezar a ver los grupos para el festival de 5 de mayo, por favor.
Sí.
¿Ok?
Sí.
Gracias.
Sí, aquí.
Gracias.
Yeah. Well, let's forget the interview. Definitely, I have the money. The money that you need. Talking about sports, what's your favorite sport?
My favorite sport? Hockey.
Hockey.
Yes. Big in Mexico.
Okay. No.
No.
That's it. No. your second favorite sport?
My second favorite is football. Not
soccer. No,
yeah,
football.
Yeah.
Okay. What's your team?
The Redskins. I love losers.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm from Washington, right?
Yeah.
Redskins. Okay.
I learned a lot of my English from watching sports because they repeat a lot of words, and it was kind of like a math equation because whenever I would see something, somebody would say a word, and then they would do the same thing again, someone would say the same word, and so I learned a lot about sports that way.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, offsides. I would start to recognize what offsides is because every time they would do an action, they would say that word. So it helped me to learn English a lot, watching football and hockey that way.
Mm-hmm. Movies? What about movies? What's your favorite movies? What's your favorite movie and what kind of movies do you like?
Oh, I love sci-fi movies, but I would say my favorite movie of all time is The Dark Knight. I love The Dark Knight so much, I have the Dark Knight logo Batman tattoo right here.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Is that like the Batman, no?
It's the most beautiful. Chris Nolan and Christian Bale, the most amazing combination in cinematic history to me.
Okay, so you like the superheroes?
No, I don't.
No,
I really don't.
Just that one.
Yeah, I actually don't like superhero movies. I just love the way Chris Nolan directs movies, and anything he does is fantastic. Except Dunkirk, that movie sucked.
have you seen any Mexican movie?
No, I haven't.
No.
Oh, Roma!
Do you see Roma?
Yeah!
We as a Mexican, we celebrate that the Roma.
Well, congratulations!
Okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
And do you only watch American movies or movies?
No,
from Europe
I like
too?
A lot. I like a lot of French movies.
And what about the series? Do you like any series?
Yes, Battlestar Galactica, the remake. That is one of my favorite series of all time. Currently I'm obsessed with The Crown, which is about Queen Elizabeth, and I'm also watching Victoria, which is about Queen Victoria. I like a lot of history stuff.
You are like my wife. She likes to watch a lot of that kind of movies to see the dresses.
Oh my God, yes, the costumes are the most amazing things. Marie Antoinette is also one of my favorite movies because of how elaborate and crazy the costumes are. Me and your wife should watch movies together.
Oh yeah. Have you? Sorry, see that emission mic. Yeah, because we used to watch movies on my bed all the time every night.
Yes, and I'm in the middle. Hello.
No.
Who wants popcorn?
Oh, yeah. No quiero esa imagen en mi mente. ¿Te gustaría tener más oportunidad, tener oportunidades, buscar oportunidades en el cine, en ese tipo de películas o películas cómicas, algo así?
I would love an opportunity to do anything scripted. I did something a while ago that was a scripted comedy, and it was so much fun. Like, I love, you know, hurting myself on purpose and, like, doing, you know, like, funny things. And
you are so funny. You are very, very, very funny.
I know. Mm-hmm. I'm just kidding.
No. Yeah, you are very... very safe
it's so fun though, like it's very fun to me, so I would love the opportunity to practice it and do it more often because I had a blast doing that mini series.
Okay.
It was just like a little like YouTube series. It wasn't anything big or important, but it was the most fun I've ever had working. Okay. Other than this, of course.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. I think you can be a star on that kind of movies because you are so funny.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, you are very nice.
You hear that, Jeff? He said I was nice.
He left. Yeah, he left. No, I know. Sé que las mujeres tienen un rato o una época en que a veces no son tan nice, que todo les molesta. Y tú debes ser como algo así, ¿no?
If you ask my boyfriend, he will tell you that I am on my period 27 days out of the month. Because that is how I act all the time.
Oh, my God.
And then I always apologize. It's either, oh, I'm so sorry, I'm about to get my period. Or, oh, I'm sorry, I'm on my period. Or, oh, I'm sorry, I just got off my period. That's why I'm acting this way. I don't know why he puts up with me.
Okay. ¿Y has pensado tener babies pronto?
Before I'm 30. I want to solidify my career, but definitely before I'm 30. I love kids, and I want kids. Look how good looking he is. I want them to come out like that.
Muy bien, muchísimo.
Sí, guapísimo.
I don't say guapísimo. ¿Cómo te enamoraste de él?
Instagram.
Really?
Yes, I followed him. Oh. And then I started liking pictures from 57 weeks into his timeline. And then the next day he direct messaged me. He was living in Denmark.
Oh,
and
okay.
We talked every day for 6 months, and then finally I decided to fly there and meet him, and immediately, it was seriously immediately, as soon as we saw each other, I knew, we both knew we were not leaving this trip without making sure that this was something that was serious forever.
Oh my God, imagine a Mexican say, Mia Khalifa is following me. Oh my God, no.
I followed you today, what are you talking about?
Really?
Yes.
Oh my God. I'm so happy about it. I can say that. Mia Khalifa is following me on Instagram.
But if your wife says anything, I will unfollow you,
no,
I promise.
No.
I don't want to get disinvited from movie night. I'll unfollow you if it upsets
her. I know. Mucho gusto en tenerte acá. Me alegra mucho conocerte. Estoy seguro que hay muchas cosas que todos los que te siguen no sabían de ti y están felices de verte.
Thank you so much for having me. And you are so sweet. This was so much fun.
Thank you very much.
This was
you,
really,
this
really
is fun.
Fun
because you are fun. Because I'm kind of nervous. I'm really shy with the girls. I used to interview musicians, just boys playing guitar. But the people pushed me a lot to interview you.
Well,
so and it's a dream to me, but I don't feel.
You made me feel very comfortable. You're very good at it. So even if you felt nervous, it didn't show. You made me feel very comfortable this whole time.
Muchísimas gracias. Thank you very much. I hope you come again when
yes.
You promote some products or something, because I can't imagine you gonna promote some accessories, merchandise, or what do you do on your YouTube channel?
My YouTube channel is my life, everything. I have actually a video coming out soon in the next couple weeks chronicling my surgery, because I got hit with a hockey puck.
I watched some.
Yeah, so they actually filmed the surgery, and we filmed like the before and after and everything.
Are you under Vicodin right now?
No, actually, because when I take it, it makes me like slur my speech and like I talk like this. So I am in so much pain right now because I haven't taken anything all day. I had my surgery 4 days ago.
Oh my God.
So all day I've been like, oh, I can't, they will think I'm drunk if I take any one of my pain pills.
I think advantage of all my surgeries to
get. Do you want some?
No.
I'm just kidding. It is scary.
Yeah.
It's scary. They gave me so many. I'm like, Jesus Christ, no wonder people get addicted to this.
Yes, yes it is. Yes.
It's dangerous.
Mm-hmm. You can sell it and make money, actually.
That's true.
Yeah.
Well, clearly I'm not getting the assistant job, so I need to make money somehow.
Oh, well, that's it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you very much, Mia.
Thank you,
me gustas mucho tu forma de ser y muchas gracias por estar aquí. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. Perdón, I'm sorry. Oh, okay. Lo siento mucho.
Okay.
Perdóname.
It's okay.
Perdóname.
It's okay. Give me a pill.
Mia Khalifa nos sorprendió con una personalidad simpatiquísima, chispeante, relajada. Es una gran persona. Fue al colegio. Es conocedora de la historia de los Estados Unidos. Habla varios idiomas. Lo mejor para Mia Khalifa. Y ustedes dicen si la trae o no la trae. Muchachos y muchachas, pues ya cumplí con su fantasía. Hagan lo que tengan que hacer, pónganle pausa al video y luego suscríbanse si no lo han hecho.